Now, let's go to St. Matthew 5. Let's go to St. Matthew 5 and look at what the Lord say out of his own mouth. St. Matthew 5. And we're going to start reading in verse 13. St. Matthew 5 and verse 13. All right, my brother, go ahead.
Ye are the salt of the earth.
That's who we are. And everybody like to put a little salt on their food, don't it? It livens it up. It keep it from being so bland, don't it? We are the salt of the earth. Go ahead.
But if the salt have lost its savor, wherewith shall it be salted?
So if we done lost our savor, we ain't got no flavor to ourselves then, what's up? We just in this old bland world, ain't we? Go ahead on and read.
It is then forth good for nothing, but to be cast out and to be trodden under foot of men.
So if we don't know the Lord, then we ain't good for nothing. Because that's the only thing that we're supposed to do, is know the word of God to teach the rest of the people. Go ahead on and read.
Ye are the light of the world.
We are the light of the world. Go ahead.
A city that is set on a hill cannot be hid. Neither do men light a candle and put it under a bushel, but on a candlestick. And it giveth light unto all that are in the house.
The Lord had a candlestick in his house, didn't he?
That's right.
A very expensive one at that, wasn't it?
That's right.
Because he paid a big price for us. He shed his blood. He died for us. Go ahead on and read.
Let your light so shine before men that they may see your good works and glorify your Father which is in heaven.
And this is what we're supposed to do. So once we come into the knowledge of the truth, we're supposed to be reversing this bad behavior that we took on ourselves. And we got to start to let our light shine so that we may be able to glorify our Father which is in heaven. So before we conclude this lesson, I want to show you something. This is from Black Voices, and it is the black buying power of our people. Now, we've been in this country for 300 and what was it, 80-something years? 393 years. And that has been total slavery, injustice, and oppression, right? And even though we have been treated like that for the last 393 years, look at what this thing says. Blacks will have more money to spend on goods and services, according to a recent report. The State of the African American Consumer Report found that black buying power is projected to reach $1.1 trillion by the year 2015. The study, which focuses on black spending, media habits, and consumer trends, report an increase in the amount of blacks attending college or earning a degree to 44% for men and 53% for women. It also found an increase in the number of African American households earning $75,000 a year or higher by almost 64%. Other notable findings in the report include, with a buying power of nearly $1 trillion a year, if blacks were a country, if blacks were a country, they'd be the 16th largest country in the world. Wow. And these are some slaves doing this. Blacks make more shopping trips than all other groups, but spend less money per trip. Blacks in higher income brackets also spend 300% more in high-end retail stores than any other income household. Yeah, name brand. We like the name brand stuff. We don't like this knockoff generic stuff. We got to have the best because this is in our DNA. There were 23.9 million active black internet users in July of 2011, 76% of whom visited a social networking site, Facebooks and MySpace and all that kind of stuff, Twitter. 23% of all blacks own a smartphone. Black Americans use more than double the amount of mobile phone voice minutes compared to whites. 1,298 minutes a month versus 606. This is not the first report to find a growth in black spending. In 2010, the African Americans revealed, that's another study, the African American revealed study report that black buying power was about $913 billion with a projected increase to $1.2 trillion by 2013. Boyce Watkins, a professor of business at Syracuse, said he was not surprised by studies with these kind of results. They ain't surprised at this. Unfortunately, when African Americans make money, they spend it. We don't use it to invest or produce, he told Black America Web. When we get our tax refund, we go straight to the stuff. Now this is us, down to a T. And this is because once upon a time, we were kings. But look at how far we done fell. But I'm gonna give you something to look forward to. Let's go to our last place. Let's go to 1 Corinthians, the second chapter. Because the only thing that the Lord has ever asked of us is to hearken unto his voice, to be obedient, right? Jesus said with his own mouth, if you love me, keep my commandments, right? That's the only thing he wants. Now I'm going to show you something. If we can reverse our trend and learn to love the Lord, this is what he have to say. 1 Corinthians 2. 1 Corinthians 2, and we're going to read one verse, verse 9. 1 Corinthians 2 and verse 9. All right, my brother, go ahead.
But as it is written, eye has not seen, nor ear heard, neither have entered into the heart of man the things which God has prepared for them that love him.
You see that? Your eye haven't seen, nor have your ear heard, nor can your mind perceive of the things that the Lord have in store for those who love him. Look at the rich riches of Solomon that we have just been in awe of. Look at the riches of our ancient forefathers that we have been in awe of. The Lord said, you ain't seen the half of it yet. I got something better than that in store for them that love me. And the way that you love him is to fear him and keep his commandments. I thank you for your time.